Hi, you're watching Casmine Report. My name is Shivam. A while ago, the Pentagon announced that the United States had developed a strategy on how to attack or disable Iran. This is actually not surprising or shocking. Every country in the world has a defensive and offensive strategies, and this means that Iran too has an attack plan. And this is what this report is about, the retaliation tactics of Iran. But Iranian influence is so widespread that it has many options, from the Kurdish populated regions to the Caucasus, to Dubai, to Gaza Strip, and to Afghanistan. Iranian tactics depends on the situation, who exactly is the opponent, and how to inflict damage upon him. I cannot cover every corner of Iranian retaliation, that's why I will focus on the primary attack plans against the United States and Israel. Let me start with Iranian proxy groups. Iran has created a network of proxies for itself. These proxies include Hamas, Hezbollah, and the Palestinian Islamic Jihad. Now, these groups were established by the native people, but it is Iran that has turned these groups into sophisticated organizations by providing them with weapons, an impressive budget, and even intelligence. Hezbollah and Hamas have both publicly stated that they will attack Israel if Iran is attacked. So Iran has a great deal of influence on Hamas and Hezbollah and the Palestinian Islamic Jihad, and by this it can target Israel. Next is Iraq. Now, historically, Iran and Iraq were part of the regional balance, but since the American invasion of Iraq, the country has been controlled by the Shia majority. Iran also has the cooperation of the Kurdish population of Iraq. So the Kurdish and Shia elements combined give Iran substantial leverage over Iraqi affairs. Basically, Iran can destabilize Iraq as a retaliation against the United States. The destabilization factor also applies to Afghanistan. Iran has a lot of experience with the Taliban and the Persian-speaking population of Afghanistan, and Iran can use these elements to keep NATO locked down in Afghanistan. The final Iranian retaliation tactic is by far the most dangerous. In fact, this strategy is so dangerous it would influence the entire world. I'm not talking about nuclear bombs or cruise missiles. I'm referring to the Strait of Hormuz, which connects the Persian Gulf with the Gulf of Oman and the Arabian Sea, and from there, the world's oceans. Now, it's going to get a bit technical, so pay close attention. There's a lot of trade going in and out the Strait of Hormuz. To be exact, 20% of the world's total shipments. But even more importantly, 90% of the Persian Gulf oil exports is transported through this strait. This represents 40% of world seaborne oil shipments. At its narrowest point, the Strait of Hormuz is 54 kilometers in wide. But in calculation of the actual navigable waters, the Strait of Hormuz is only 32 kilometers wide. So 32 kilometers is deep enough for 40% of world seaborne oil traffic to pass. That is not much, and that makes the Strait of Hormuz an extremely dangerous place. Now consider the fact that Iran has anti-ship missiles and submarines and warplanes targeting this narrow strait, not to mention a vast amount of naval mines to be deployed. If the Strait of Hormuz would be blocked for a week, it would mean disaster for the entire world. Even a one-day blockade would have grave consequences, as it would create the image that there is an energy crash, and this would inflate energy prices, and from there it would lead to global inflation. And this all amidst the current global recession. So an attack on the Strait of Hormuz would have global consequences. And this includes consequences for Iran as well. That's why for Iran, this is the last resort. These were the primary retaliation capabilities of Iran. A strike against Iran would have to be coordinated by taking these elements into consideration, especially the Strait of Hormuz. This was a Caspian report by me, Shirvan. I hope this video was insightful. Salam. So.